Hello students, welcome once again to this channel. Today we are going to see the fourth derivation of chapter 2 electric potential and capacitance in CBSE physics class 12. Come on, let us move on to the derivation. Electric potential due to a dipole at a point on the equatorial line. So this is the electric dipole and the line which is drawn perpendicular to the dipole is called as the equatorial line. Now the point lies on this equatorial line. So at this point only we are going to calculate the electric potential. Now let us have a close look at the diagram. AB is the dipole. Here minus Q, here plus Q, which is separated by a small distance 2A. Now I have split them into two. From A to O, that is the center of this dipole, as A. Then from O to B as A. Now what we are going to do is, by using Pythagoras theorem, we are going to calculate the distance AP. Now let us take this triangle first. It is a right angle triangle. So in triangle AOP, using Pythagoras theorem, AP squared is equal to AO squared plus OP squared. So in the next step, AO is nothing but small a, so a squared, and again OP is nothing but small r, so r squared. So if we take this square out, then this side it will become square root. So therefore AP is equal to square root of a squared plus r squared. Similarly, so I have written here AP is equal to square root of a squared plus r squared. Similarly, in this right angle triangle, that is BOP also, if we calculate the distance BP, then it will become square root of a squared plus r squared. Now let us see how it comes. In triangle BOP, BP squared, here you see, BP squared is equal to BO squared plus OP squared. That's what I have written here. BP squared is equal to BO squared plus OP squared. So BO is nothing but small a, so a squared, plus OP is nothing but r, so r squared. So if we take square this side, then here it will become square root, so square root of a squared plus r squared. So BP is equal to square root of a squared plus r squared. That's what I have written over here. BP is equal to square root of a squared plus r squared. Then electric potential at point P due to charge plus Q is. So we know the general formula for electric potential due to a point charge. V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. So here also V1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by, the distance here is BP. So in the next step you have already calculated the value for BP. So V1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by square root of a squared plus R squared. Similarly, electric potential at point P due to charge minus Q is, V2 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. In the place of Q, I have written minus Q, and the distance is AP. The value of AP has been calculated already. So V2 is equal to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by square root of a squared plus r squared. So now we have calculated V1 and V2 separately for point charges. Now we are going to calculate the electric potential for a dipole. So electric potential at point P due to the dipole is, here we need to add both the potentials at A and B. So V is equal to V1 plus V2. So I have written the expression for V1 and here I have written the expression for V2. Both are similar in nature but opposite in signs. This is plus and this is minus. So both get cancelled. So we will get 0. So V is equal to 0. So the electric potential due to a dipole at a point on the equatorial line is 0. So with this, this video has come to an end. Let us see another derivation in the next video.
Like, share and comment and subscribe our channel and click the bell button for more videos. Thank you.